Welcome to all, myself Professor Deshmukh MS presenting the theory lectures based on the subject that is dynamic of machinery, having unit number 4 that is a balancing, and which contain the things that is a balancing of the inline engine. Some of the introductions to the balancing, we have to see what is a balancing exactly. So balancing is just only the coincidence of the or coincides of the two points, that is the center of gravity and center of rotation, for a system to be completely balanced, both forces and couple. Okay, if that one single plane is there, that is only the forces balance, only the forces is acting. But when there is something distance on different planes, so under that conditions, that is couple polygon should be closed in order to prevent the effect of that of your centrifugal force. So this is the case. Again, for a system to be completely balanced, that is the same couple or the forces, both are closed. Now come to the inline engine. So what exactly the inline engine is there? An inline engine is one which where the cylinder are arranged in a single plane, and one behind the others. Many of the passenger cars are in the, such as that Maruti 800 in Centro, Honda City. So these are the inline engine. Means what? All cylinders are arranged in a single line. That is single line. In the single line, all cylinders are arranged. Means what? In this case, that is a multi cylinders are there. Okay, and they are having some practical examples. Are that is a passenger cars. Then again, Maruti 800. Then again Centro, then again Honda City, then again Honda CRV, Toyota, Corolla. These are the examples of this four cylinder inline engine. In a reciprocating engine, the reciprocating masses is transferred to the crank pin. The axial components of resulting centrifugal forces parallel to the that of your axis of cylinder is a primary unbalanced force. So what is given here? The axial component of the resulting centrifugal force is parallel to that of your axis of cylinder. It is a primary unbalanced forces. So this is happen in the case of your inline engine. Now these are the balancing of that inline engine. These are the M1, M2, M3, these are the three masses are in line only. Okay, R1, R2, R3, these are the crank radius. M1, R1, then again just resolve these forces. Okay, just taking the omega square as a constant one or the common one. So MR, that is M1, R1. Vector quantity, then again M2 R2, that is for the fourth second, and for third, that is M3 R3, and we got some resultant MR, then again RR. Okay, and along the line of stroke, just resolve the particular forces, that is MRR cos theta. Now, what are the forces acting on this? That is primary and secondary. So, primary force, that is the summation m r omega square cos theta, this is equation number 1. Then again primary couple, that is m r omega square l into cos theta. What is the l? That is the length, okay, from the reference point, or length of connecting rod, we can say that. Secondary force, that is summation of m r here, that is having the primary, that is omega, that is the 2 omega bracket square divided by 4 l into cos 2 theta. Then again secondary couple, summation of m r twice omega bracket square divided by 4 n into l divided into cos 2 theta. So these are the m r omega square divided by n l cos 2 theta. This is the case. So what is the basic difference between primary forces and secondary forces? That is m r omega square cos theta in the case of primary. In the second, that is twice omega square bracket square, okay, divided by 4 n, and theta become the twice to theta. Okay, couple same similar, that only the difference is what? In the primary, that we are having the only theta, here I having the 2 theta. Again, omega just converted into the twice omega. And it's something that 4n will be having. Okay? What is the comparative point between force and couple? Only the difference of your length. Okay? Inline two cylinder engines. The two cylinder engines cranks are 180 degree apart and have equal reciprocating masses. That we are having equal rotating masses, that is 180 degree, and having the equal reciprocating masses. Just let's see the content. That the case, look at this here, where theta, okay, in the primary, that two masses, that is 1/2, secondary having the again 180 degree difference, phase angle, we can say that 180 degree plus theta, that reference is plane, the primary crank, and that again, the primary polygon, okay, we will draw here, simple, the two masses are in a equal but opposite, okay, m r omega square l cos theta. That's the case. The what is the difference that the two cylinder that two cranks having the 180 degree apart and I have the equal reciprocating masses. Inline 2 degree cylinder, same. That's the angle. Now something analytically related to find out the primary forces and the couple. So what are the some steps you have to follow? That is a first one, position of your crank, that is theta. Again the maximum values of these forces and the couples varying instant to the instant are equal to values as given by equivalent rotating masses at the crank pin. If a particular position of the crankshaft is considered, the above expressions may not give the maximum values. For example, the maximum value of primary couples is mr omega square into l, and this value is obtained at the crank position theta degree and 180 degree. However, if the crank position are assumed at 90 degree and 270 degree, the values obtained will be zero. Now this value is obtained at the crank positions theta degree and 180 degree. However, if the crank positions are assumed at the 90 degree and 270 degree, positions of cylinder now the position is similar, just like we have seen in the previous case, that is L by 2 theta angle. Then again length L. Having the case of this, now these are the secondary force polygons. In primary, that is a theta plus 180 degree, while in the case of this, that is a 180 degree plus theta, here that is 360 degree plus twice theta, okay. So this is all about the case, that is a once again simple, that is a for the primary we have to consider 2 theta, secondary and primary for that is a theta. So we have to balance by the case. So again it will be the quite easier for this inline engine, number of cylinder you have to balance. What is basically the things, that is all cylinders are in a inline. So these are the things.